Hello and welcome to Beer Goggles Reviews with me, Terry Kay. I think I'm kind of being... Hold on. Shall I get it out first? Kind of in a little beer stash here. Just been down where was it? Tesco's, was it? Tesco's. Just been down to Tesco's. And I do pay for beers. And I've seen this one, and it is a, what does it say on it? It is a Christmas ale,
and a Christmas ale said there's
4% ABV, and it is by Triple F Brewery, and it is Christmas ale, micro brewed for maximum flavours. Now, I've never had a Triple F before, and this is brewed kind of like for Tesco's, one of their little kind of, they'll put their own little labels on them and stuff. And it's in a little presentation box. I'm going to get it out of the box now. Little silvery lid thing. And then you got, zip, out it comes. And it is, there it is, the bottle there. Do you Triple F, there's a brewery and everything. So if I don't like it, I'll complain to them. Please recycle the bottle and everything, all that business. Once upon a time, I remember back in the day, you used to get money back on bottles. You don't get that anymore, do you? Just recycle them out the goodness of your heart, innit? Otherwise, you'll get in trouble for throwing it in the bin. Oh, I don't know. It's terrible over here, it is. Right, get on with it and stop moaning. Let's crash this open and see what we get. I can't really tell you a lot about the brewery or... Core, that's a hard old, tough old lid. And the old crown there. Nice, plain, shiny little red one. I kind of like that. That's cute. That's cute, I like that. Put it on there because I've got to recap the beer probably. Yeah, I can't tell you a lot about the brewery. Can't tell you a lot about the beer because I've gone straight in... kind of going in blind, and which I like to do. Occasionally I'll read up on the brewery, but most of the time I like to sort of go in blind. So I'm just pouring the beer out. Excuse me looking away from you as I'm talking. Ever so rude. I like to kind of go in blind and then be able to give you taste notes that ain't preconceived, that ain't been kind of fed to me beforehand. And you know, when you see people look up on Rate Beer and Beer Advocate, and it's like, oh, I see it on this one, and whatever everyone else wants to do, it's all cool. You know, everyone's got different styles, but me personally, I think once someone tells you you're going to taste tangerines, you start tasting tangerines. If the beer ain't talking to me, I don't want someone else telling me what to think, you know. I want the beer to tell me what it's giving me. Rent over. Right, that is the very, very beautiful colour. If you look on the card, you often get a better representation of the colour you're getting. So on there, it looks a bit darker on the screen. But on the card there, just at the top of that card, you're getting, on the top of that little shine, I should say, you're getting a better representation as the light goes through. Ever so slightly cloudy. And that will probably be from bottle conditioning. Let's have a little look, see what we got. Yeah, you got, that's good to see. I like that. Bit of yeast down at the bottom there. I don't know if you can see that. Let's get this one out of my hand. Get me a torch on him. Oh. But if I show you down the bottom there, let's see it. Bit of lumps, bumps, cheese, peas and carrots down the bottom there. And there's stuff coming off of it. So it could be that it's still fermenting happily in there. So it might be, excuse me, might be a very fresh one. All good. And I've probably shook it up getting it out of the bag. So if it is slightly hazy, my fault, I just got it out of the bag. But then I didn't know. Whatever. Who cares? You can't tell for a brown bottle anyway. Cheers. Let's have a little sniff. Not getting a hell of a lot. I'm going to try to twirl it around a little bit on the flat surface there. Now, getting a tiny little hint of peaches, and a hint of clementines, tangerine sort of thing. Nice little bouncy, happy notes. A little bit of a kind of biscuity sort of malty flavour smell there. Let's dive in. Cheers, bottoms up. Oh, Merry Christmas, by the way. Yeah, it's pleasant. It's very nice, yeah. It's kind of one of these sit back with happy little beers. It's, and also if you, you know, if you're buying it for dad or buying it for granddad or whoever, you know, and you're not sure what sort of beers they like, it's not going to offend anyone. It's not going to go, oh, this is horrible. You know, if he drinks Guinness, he's going to drink that and go, well, that's not bad. If he drinks lager, he's going to drink it and go, that's nice, I like that, you know. Especially if it's a McLager drinker, he'll taste that and go, Jesus, that's lovely. Where did you get that? What was this, you know? And hopefully you might convert him. Yeah, that's lovely. It's got lovely little sort of clean sort of notes here. Sort of nice, like I say, it ain't offensive to anyone. It's not going to sort of go, big, malty, dark, sort of all that business, you know. Or hops and all that. It's just a right amount of hops to kind of busy itself up and just bring, you know, bitter down those sweet flavours, and a right amount of sweet flavours to have a nice marriage there and work with those hops. That's a pretty thing, a very pretty thing. I think you need some sort of maybe advice on there on the bottle about bottle. Oh, it says that. Yeah, bottle conditioned beer. Please pour carefully, malted barley, yeast, hops, water, and sediments. That's good, you know. It might frighten a few people that get it as a present. They'll go, oh, bits in the bottom. If you're getting it, look, let it settle. Put it in the fridge for a little while. Let it settle down. Like, get it out of the fridge. Let it kind of warm a little bit until it's kind of as cold as, like, tap water. You know, that's been running for a long while. Don't tip it. Don't sort of look at it. Look at that cap. Look at this and that business. Don't do all that. Sort of just take it around like that, the right way up, you know. Put it down nice and careful. Don't boom on the counter. Open it careful. Pour it in one pour. Don't pour. Oh, then pour it again because you just swoosh it all up. Pour it all in one pour. Leave a little bit in the bottom. And the shoulder on it will sort of hold on to that sediment. That being said, there could be cheese, peas and carrots in this. There is a little bit of movement. Like if you're twirling it, I don't know if you can see now. If you're twirling, this is one of them with cheese, peas and carrots. So you're going to have to be very careful. Look, if I swirl that, you can see there's a lot of cheese, peas and carrots. Don't be put off by that. Just pour it carefully. Actually, I'll be drinking that anyway because it doesn't bother me, and it's, you know, actually yeast is full of vitamins, full of goodness, you know. It's not going to harm you unless you've got some allergy or whatever, and then you shouldn't be drinking beer, should you? But I would say that one there, I'll show you that because you won't see the bottle until you open it. So that one there, Christmas ale. From Triple F, definitely buy it, try it and like it. I think I paid something silly like £1 for them or something like that. That's why I've got a whole bag of them. So if I didn't like it, someone would be getting them for presents. But yes, I hope no one watches this. No one does, don't worry. But yeah, definitely get that one. Not for one for eating with the Christmas dinner, but one for kind of having a beer with after and all that, and kind of with when you go to the party and whatever else, take a few of them around. Granddad's gonna love one, dad's gonna love one, yeah, mum or whatever, whoever. Absolutely beautiful. Cheers, bottoms up, chin chin, Merry Christmas. I say, brother. Hello. Oops, someone. I'll do it again, shall I? Ready? Take two. I'll try take three. Take three. Take four. Take four. Try take five. I don't want some mat with me today. Take five. Oh, Christ. Take six. Oh, now I'm getting the ump. Take seven. Hello and welcome to Beer Goggles Reviews with me, Terry Kay.